just in our minds. And the things that we are searching for, they're sure we'll never find. But what I've got within my heart, I know is real. For when he saved me, he gave me something I can feel. Something I can feel. Something I know is real. In troubled times, he's peace of mind, a hand to hold on to. And there are those who say that God is dead. And there's others who will laugh and mock at the words my Jesus said. They say that our emotions are just a cheap thrill. But I'm so just in our minds, and the things that we are searching for, they're sure we'll never find. But what I've got within my heart, I know is real. For when he I say that God is dead. And there's others who will laugh and mock at the words my Jesus said. They say that our emotions are just a cheap thrill, but I'm so glad when he saved me, he gave me something I can feel. Just in our mind, and the things that we are searching for, they're sure we'll never find. But what I've got within my heart, I know is real. For when he saved me, he gave me something is dead. And there's others who will laugh and mock at the words my Jesus said. They say that our emotions are just a cheap thrill, but I'm so I God's just in our minds. And the things that we are searching for, they're sure we'll never find. But what I've got within my heart, I know is real. For when He saved me, He gave me something I can feel. Something I can feel. Something I know is real. In troubled times, He's peace of mind. A hand to hold on to. And there are those who say that God is dead. And there's others who will laugh and mock at the words my Jesus said. They say that our emotions are just a cheap thrill. But I'm so just in our minds. And the things that we are searching for, they're sure we'll never find. But what I've got within my heart, I know is real. For when He saved me, He gave me something I can't. say that God is dead. And there's others who will laugh and mock at the words my Jesus said. They say that our emotions are just a cheap thrill, but I'm so glad when he saved me, he gave me something I can feel. Nothing
you a message this morning. Now, did it hit our hearts today? And let me just say this, God is a jealous God. Amen. I know he made the comment, well, everybody's a scholar nowadays. Amen. Everybody's a theologian nowadays. When you go talk to them, amen. Well, I believe God is love. Amen. Hey, appreciate the devotion this morning. God is love, but he's also a God of wrath, as he already mentioned. And I'm telling you, amen, the Bible says he will laugh at your calamity. Now, does that sound like God? That's God. God is love. Does that sound like God? That's God. Amen. He's a merciful and he's a gracious God. Hallelujah. Boy, I thought you was going to preach the sermon this morning. Hallelujah. But I tell you, we're living in some perilous times. Let me tell you something, friend. If you've ever wondered if Jesus is coming, amen. Let me tell you, he's coming. Amen. What's happened over the last several months? I'm telling you, it's a leading up, amen. I ain't saying this pandemic ain't real, amen. But I think that God has allowed it to lead up to, amen, a lot of different things that's coming on this world, coming on this nation. One world government's coming, amen. You need to get on board our preacher. I don't believe that. We got a president to do something about that. Oh, yeah. He sure will. Uh-oh, now you got me talking about Trump, don't you? Hallelujah. Amen. Let me tell you something. I don't trust the government. Period. Amen. I thank God I've heard more morals out of this administration than a long time. Now, some of you should have shouted amen right there. Why are you afraid, amen? You afraid to be a Trump man or woman? Hallelujah. I don't like his mealy mouth, amen, but he's done a lot. He's done more for the Christian than he has, amen, than in the decades. Can I get an amen right there? Amen. Well, ain't going to get it political. I always said, and I've always been taught, politics shouldn't be in church. I've got a totally different thought of that now. It ought to be in the house of God. Now, you got your right to vote who you want to vote in that day. That's our God-given right. Amen. But one thing I ain't a voting, I'm not a voting against this book. And I'll say it again. You say, well, what if this and that and this stands halfway? We'll vote for one of the lesser evils. But everyone's one most closer to this. It's who I'll vote for. Thank God for the few amens. Amen. Some of you don't like it. Well, I'm not apologizing. Amen. We're in the Word. Amen. The Word has set you free. The truth has set you free. Amen. All God people said. Praise the Lord. How many has signed up for a kit for the soul winning class? If you signed up and bought a kit, raise your hand. I'd like to see all those. You signed up and bought a kit for the soul winning class. Keep them up there. Okay, here's what we're going to do. I'm going to talk to Brother Travis about that. It's going to be on Wednesday nights. I'm not telling you right now when it's going to start. I'm going to discuss it with Brother Travis. There may be some that has come in that's changed your mind and want a kit. Is there anybody would like to have one of those kit? And you've not got one. Let me know right now. How much were they, brother? $35? $35 for the kit. Amen. That takes you through a 12-week course, and it'll be on Wednesday nights. You say, well, don't you furnish that? No, you put a little bit of more of your money in it, and you might do better. All God people say it. Praise the Lord. Some of you already forgot it. I better go on. Hallelujah. Ain't God good?
Amen.
All right, let's all, everybody that can and will, I'd like for us to come and gather around the altar. And if you've got a special request, you can make that known. Everybody that can, come and gather around the altar. Amen. And if you're not coming to the altar, let's stand. All right.
I can't remember my brother-in-law, Willard.
All right. Do pray for Brother Keith's brother-in-law, Willard. Any other requests? Pray for Magenta and all these tests. Mom will be going to the oncologist on Tuesday. She'll be having a bone scan on Wednesday. So I desire your prayers concerning that. Continue to be cancer free. Any other? All right. Pray for Brother Keith's mother. Amen. Yeah, we got some that's vacationing. I know my family is traveling today and tomorrow, so if you will, lift them up to the Lord. And Amber and them's traveling back home today, so we got some folks out today, so pray for them. Any others before we pray? Yes, ma'am. Lord, touch. Amen. Remember our nation. Remember all these that's on the cross. Brother Travis, you lead us off to the Lord in prayer, would you? Heavenly Father, we love you. I thank you, God, for the privilege, God, of prayer. Lord, to be able, God, to be back in your house. Be able, dear Lord, call upon your name. Lord, I thank you, God, for the good devotion this morning. Lord, help us, dear God, to be in your will. Thank you, God, for the good power and presence and spirit, God, that we've already failed. God, touch these, Lord, that's on this cross, that's been pinned there, God, by a heart that, Lord, is burdened for them, dear God, that is concerned for them. I pray, God, that you save that one that's lost, God, on that cross. That one that's backslid, then make their way back to an old-fashioned altar of repentance. God, that one, dear God, that is sick, God, touch and heal and make well. Touch Magenta, the testing coming up, and these brother-in-laws, dear God, and all these spoken requests today. God, your will, God, be accomplished. God, I ask, Lord, to touch Mom. Dear God, on Tuesday, an oncologist report. Lord, to be good. Thank you for letting it be good. Lord, I pray for the bone scan on Wednesday, God. I pray that continue to be cancer-free in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Ghost. For it's by your stripes we are healed. By your stripes we are saved. Now, Lord, I pray, God, that you bless this service. Lord, touch the bless the offering, bless the gift, bless the giver, bless, dear Lord, the preaching, the singing, whatever's done today. God, you be lifted up, magnified. Lord, touch God in this soul winning, Lord, classes or course, God, on Wednesdays, dear God. Lord, we just give you praise. We give you honor. Lord, touch all those, Lord, that are unconcerned and unfaithful. Touch, dear God, all those that are traveling. God, I pray that you give traveling graces, dear Lord. And I just love you, God. And I pray you give strength where strength's needed. God, you give encouragement, Lord, encouragement where those are discouraged, God. Lord, help us, God, to be a vessel of honor, God, not of dishonor. Now, Lord, I pray to God that you'd help things to get back around normal, God, around going home church. And I pray, God, that Lord, virus, oh God, you'd suppress that in the name of the Father, the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost. We love you. God, we give you honor, we give you glory. God, do save that that's lost. God, those, Lord, that's been talked to this week, God, I pray, send Holy Ghost conviction their way. In Christ's name. Amen. 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 Have the usher come around. Amen. And we're going to take up our morning tithes and offerings. Hey, is he getting the offering? Is he doing the offering for me? Okay. Are you doing the offering, brother? Okay. Here's what we do. Now, after the offering plate pass you, amen, let's fellowship in the Lord. Hallelujah. Somebody said, well, how do you want me to fellowship? I start saying any way you want to. Wave and salute somebody. Listen, I just respect people's space. Amen. All right. Thank you. it, all right? All right, we need to do, let's see. This turned to page 110. Amen. Any of our visitors with us this morning, God bless you for being here. Hallelujah. It's good to see Ray back there. See him walk in. Thank you for being here, Ray. Hallelujah. And I tell you, let's pray for those. I tell you, we've got folks. This church I ain't seen in months. Amen. That burdens my soul. Amen. Now, it's one thing, amen, to be cautious about this virus, but don't go nowhere else. All God people saying, the truth will set you free. Praise the Lord. It's either right or it's wrong. Praise the Lord. Well, hallelujah. Amen. Well, I know it, I think, but let's turn to page 110. Heaven's Jubilee. If I'm too loud, I'll sound as good as that sound man back there makes me sound. Amen. It's sing it like, hey, before, I'm not getting right into it. Have me saved. Amen. All right, let's sing it like we're saved. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Somebody says, I can't carry a tune in the bucket. Well, carry the bucket and it'll still sound all right. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Amen. Let's sing it.
Some glad morning we shall see Jesus in the air, coming after you and me, joys ours to share. What rejoicing there will be when the saints shall rise, heading for that jubilee yonder in the skies. Oh, what singing, oh, what shouting on that happy morning when we all shall rise. What glory, hallelujah, when we meet our blessed Savior in the sky. Seems that now I almost see all the sainted dead rising for that jubilee that is just ahead. In the twinkling of an eye, change with them to be all the living saints who fly to that jubilee. Oh, what singing.
Yeah, sing it.
Oh, what glory. Hallelujah. When we meet our blessed Savior in the sky.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Well, I'm looking forward to it, don't you?
When with all that heavenly host we begin to sing, singing in the Holy Ghost, how the heavens will ring. Millions there will join the song, with them we shall be. Praising Christ through ages long, heaven's jubilee. Oh, what singing, oh, what shouting on that happy morning when we all shall rise. Oh, what glory, hallelujah, when we meet our blessed Savior in the sky.
All right, how many miss choir? If we had it, who would come? Raise your hand to the choir. I ain't saying we're having it, but you're singing there. Amen. All God people said, hallelujah. You may be seated if you can, church.
Praise God.
What you got? Okay. All right. You pray for Angie. You lift her up to the Lord. Somebody might have a testimony for Jesus. It's okay. We get some extra music up here. All right, you pray for her. God is good. Altar's open if you need to pray.
I've seen the righteous man say,
suffer in pain, and it looked like the wicked would go free. And in my frustration, that just didn't seem right to me. See me through, Lord, I still trust you.
What a blessing. I'm glad I trust Him. Proverbs 3, 5, and 6. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart. Lean not to thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge Him, and He shall direct thy path. That bless your heart this morning? I still trust you. Sometimes life gets overwhelming. Sometimes life gets discouraging and depressing. What do you do, preacher, when you just feel like there's no place to go? What do you do, preacher, when you just feel like that there's nowhere to turn? How many's ever been there? Feel like, I mean, you really felt like you're saved, you're Christian, but you felt like, man, where do I go? I mean, even being saved and born again, you'll still doubt God. But you still got to go to God. Amen? Hey, God's good this morning. God's good. Hallelujah. Have you obeyed the Lord? Good to see you in the Lord's house. Pray for all those that are not here. How many have your Bibles? Let's lift them up for the Lord. Amen. Give God a good wave offering with the Holy Scripture. Love your Bible. Embarrass your flesh. That's the most precious book you'll hold in your hand. Amen. Is the Word of God. You know that's the best-selling book in the world? Did you know that? The best, I mean, man, you hear all these bestsellers, and I mean, these news commentators come out and they got a number one book and they got all this and all that. That's the best-selling book. I believe it's the best-selling book, but I believe it's the least read. Best-selling, but the least read. All right, if you got your Bibles, I'd like for you to stand. Amen. Reverence the Word of God. Acts chapter 1. Acts chapter 1 today. Acts chapter 1. Amen. Brother Keith Webb, if you will, before I do that, pray for me and my family. We'll be singing revival at the Chesney Free Will Baptist Church on October the 5th. Is that right? I believe that's on Monday, October the 5th, in their revival. So anybody like to go down, be a part of that revival? Amen, Brother Jeremy Allman. I remember Brother Jeremy. Brother Jeremy, before he started pastoring, preached here several times. Amen. But he's the new pastor there at the Chesney Free Will Baptist Church. Tuck Childers. What was his first name? James Childers. Many, many years Brother James had been at that church. Amen. But anyway, if anybody would like to go, you're welcome to go. Brother, would you lead us off and bless the reading? Yes, Lord.
We know that you are the one and only God, Lord. Lord, touch our pastor now as he preaches, Lord. Just anoint him from on high, Lord. Lord, help him to preach with everything that you give him, Lord. And we'll accept that. We'll love you. We'll love him, Lord. We ask all these things in your name, Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Acts chapter 1, let's begin reading in verse number 1. The former treaties have I made, O Theopolis, of all that Jesus began both to do and teach, until the day in which he was taken up, after that he, through the Holy Ghost, had given commandments unto the apostles whom he had chosen. Listen, when we get saved, it don't stop there. The Holy Ghost give commandments unto the apostles whom he had chosen. Remember that. He gave a command. Look at verse 3. To whom also he showed himself alive after his passion by many infallible proofs, being seen of them 40 days and speaking of the things pertaining to the kingdom of God, and being assembled together with them, commanded them that they should not depart from Jerusalem, but wait for the promise of the Father, which, saith he, ye have heard of me. For John truly baptized with water, but ye shall be baptized with the Holy Ghost not many days hence. When they therefore were come together, they asked of him, saying, Lord, wilt thou at this time restore again the kingdom to Israel? And he said unto them, it is not for you to know the times or the seasons which the Father hath put in his own power, but ye shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost is come upon you. And ye shall be witnesses unto me both in Jerusalem and in all Judea and in Samaria and unto the uttermost part of the earth. And then the Bible says in verse 9, and when he had spoken these things while they beheld, he was taken up, and a cloud received him out of their sight. And while they looked steadfastly toward heaven, as he went up, behold, two men stood by them in white apparel, which also said, ye men of Galilee, why stand ye gazing up into heaven? This same Jesus, which is taken up, hallelujah, taken up from you into heaven, shall also come in like manner as ye have seen him go into heaven. How many believe Jesus is coming? How many really know he's coming? You may be seated. May the good Lord add his blessings to the reading of the scripture. Well, I want you to remember verse number 2, how the Bible says that the Holy Ghost gave them commandments, amen, to take, amen, out into the world. And I want you to keep that thought in mind. Just my introduction this morning, amen, and I looked up the word command amen, on the computer there, Googled that. And how many's going to pray for us? And it says give an authoritative order. That's what command means, is to give an authoritative order. I went on down and looked at the synonyms of this word command, and it said commandment. And that's what we just read in the book here in the Bible. The Bible says that he gave them commandments. Not only that, but it's direction. So that command means, amen, a demand. It means instruction. It means it even gave one synonym as a mandate. That's what it is, amen. In other words, it's a mandate, it's a command, amen, from, amen, the master. It's a command, amen, from the commander. How many thank God you got a great commander and his name's Jesus, amen. Amen, it means charge, amen, it means commission, amen. Do you know the Bible teaches us that we're to be a good soldier? Amen, of Jesus Christ, the Bible teaches us that. I worry about that today. Listen, friend, we got churches. Does our churches today look like soldiers? I mean, you think about that. Our churches today look like soldiers. I'm talking about ready, amen, for war. I'm talking about ready, amen, to take on the battle, amen, to ready, amen, to take the command, amen, from the commander, take the direction or the charge, amen, or the instruction, amen, from or the order from the commander. I be honest with you, there's not many soldiers in our churches, amen, today. I'm talking about, you know, the Bible says for we're to endure hardness. To endure hardness. Amen. I'll be honest with you. Even this pandemic has took a toll on you, Pastor. Now, when I say that, you just have to be a preacher. You just have to be a pastor. And I'll be honest, I'm getting about tired of it. Amen. And I know it ain't real. Amen. But I'm going to preach on this subject. Amen. Glory to God. This morning, amen, by the help of the Lord, a charge from the commander, a charge from the master. As I was thinking about this, you know, God didn't save us to sit down. God didn't save us, amen, just to come to the church on Sunday morning and sit in a pew. And I tell you, if you're happy with a 10:45 service, shame on you. We shouldn't just be happy with a 10:45 service. Amen, I tell you what, I miss Sunday school. Amen. But sad part is a lot don't miss the Sunday school part. Amen. You know why? Because you're backsliding. Yeah, it's either the truth or it ain't the truth. Amen. And I tell you what, you got a lot of churches today that are getting away from it anyway. Amen. Trying to take it out. I'm just still an old-fashioned preacher. All God people saying. I believe the first charge, amen, this morning by the help of the Lord, or the first challenge, or the first command or mandate, you may call it, the first charge this morning would be in 2 Timothy 4, 1 through 5, is for an unchallenged message, amen. Do you know we have an unchallenged message? Somebody said, preacher, it's just like the brothers teaching this morning in his devotion. I mean, everybody's a scholar. Everybody knows more Bible than you do, amen. I tell you what the problem is, amen, they try to turn this word around and justify, amen, to convince them that their sin, amen, is all right. Let me tell you something, amen, if sin was sin 50 years ago, it's still sin today. If the Bible says it's wrong, it's still wrong.
Amen. That's 2 Timothy 4:1-5. He said, I charge thee, hey, therefore before God. They say, Paul was telling Timothy, I give you a charge. In other words, here is a command. Here is a mandate. Here is some instruction that I'm going to leave for you. Amen. Here's a demand. He said, and the Lord Jesus Christ, who shall judge the quick and the dead at his appearing in his kingdom. He said, preach the word. He said, preach the word. I want to ask you a question. How many churches are you seeing preaching? I'm talking about preaching the word. Anybody know what preaching is? Amen. Let me remember Isaiah when he said to lift up thy voice as a trumpet. He said to lift up thy voice and spare not. Hallelujah. I don't know what you... I had a guy one time in the church, in the old church many years ago. I walked out the door that day and I preached, man. Or at least I thought I did, Brother Keith. He said, I enjoyed your talk today. I thought, huh? You enjoyed my talk today. I don't want nobody to leave this congregation and just say, and say, I enjoyed your talk today. I want you to leave this congregation and say, I want those that are listening on Facebook and say, hey, preacher, I enjoyed the preaching of the Word of God. Amen. He charged, hey, we've got an unchallenged message. Amen, we need to preach the word. He said, Timothy, amen, he said, preach the word. We got so many, amen, it's a preaching, amen, everything else. Amen, let me tell you something, friend. If it ain't what thus saith the word of God, you say, preacher, you get up and you preach things I've heard before. That's all right, you just don't, hey, you just pray for your preacher. All God's people say it. Sure enough, preach the word. He said, be instant in season, out of season. What does that mean? That means what it says. It means, amen, preach, amen, when they're expecting you to preach. And preach, amen, when they're not expecting you to preach. Preach, amen, when, hey, preach when it's good weather to preach in spiritually. And preach, amen, when the weather ain't that good to preach in. Preach anyway. Preacher, if you preach in good weather, thank God he gives me good weather. Amen, to preach in. I'm talking spiritually. Then there's been times, amen, I've had bad weather, Brother Keith. I've had bad weather to preach in. You say, what do you do? Hey, there's one time in my ministry I became a little bit intimidated. Somebody said, preacher, I just don't see you as bold as you are. I just don't see how you could become intimidated. Well, don't you misunderstand me. There's one time in the ministry I became intimidated by certain people in the church. Amen. You said, preacher, what happened? Amen. I tell you what happened. In other words, what I'm trying to say by intimidated, Brother Keith, the devil, amen, was popping up on my shoulder and said, you better not preach this. You better not preach as hard. You better not say, in other words, these certain things, amen, or you're going to get in trouble. You said, preacher, so what did you do? I tell you what I done. I prayed over it. Hallelujah, prayed over it. What'd you do? First of all, I ain't up here to tickle your ears. I ain't up here, amen, to pat you on the back. Hey, everybody with the preacher. Somebody say amen, rather. I'm not up here, amen, to tickle your fancy. Amen, I tell you what I done. I prayed over it when I got behind the sacred dais. Amen, and opened up the word of God. Amen, you say, what'd you do? I preached it anyway. What the devil's telling me not to preach, I preached it anyway. You say, why would you do that? I tell you why. Amen, you don't dictate to me what I preach. You don't tell me what I preach. Hey, man, I ain't taking orders from you. I'm not taking a mandate from you. I'm not taking a charge from you. And when you tell me what I can preach, hey, man, hey, somebody said one time a preacher ended up, amen, in the church, a visiting preacher. I don't know if they're looking for a pastor or whatever, but whatever the situation was, said the deacons, handed him the sermon when he went in to preach that morning. True story, my understanding. Deacons handed him the sermon or the pulpit committee or something. Somebody said, preacher, what would you to do? Well, after hearing this story, I don't know what I'd done then because I ain't never been done that to. They probably know better. You said, what would you to do? After thinking about now, I ever walk into church and they hand me the sermon, I'm going to take it. I'm going to say, thank you very much. I appreciate that. I'll even sit down and look over it. Because I want to see what they want me to preach. You say, what's going to happen? Abe, what would you do? You mean to tell me if you was at a visiting church preacher, or if you was going in view of a call, or if you was going, amen, for a candidate for another church or whatever, you mean to tell me? Let me tell you something, friend. Hey, man, I'm not going to stand before God. Hey, I got a mandate. I've got, glory to God. I got a command from the Heavenly Father. I've got a command from the Master. I got a command, hallelujah, for, hey, the glory. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. The general in the sky, his name's Jesus, and I ain't going to give an account to you. I'll have to give an account to God. Amen. That's the reason, amen, our churches, amen, ain't got no power in them. You say, we ain't got many people here this morning. I'm still going to preach. Amen. He said, in season, out of season. He said, reprove. Sometimes, amen, preachers got to reprove. Sometimes the preacher got, Bible says rebuke. Sometimes the preacher has to rebuke. I don't like to preach. Listen, I hope you don't think I'm trying to beat you over the head. Amen. Listen, somebody say, you're awful bold this morning. Amen. It's the Holy Ghost in me. Amen. I'm saying this, rebuke. Sometimes a preacher has to rebuke the member. I don't like to do that. I don't like to just come out and rebuke somebody. I've got people saying, you say, oh, but you ought to do it through the sermon. Well, a lot of times the Lord will let it come through the sermon. Amen. But there's sometimes, Brother Keith, amen, you pastored long enough. Amen. Sometimes rebuking's got to come. Amen. I mean, you just don't stand around and let people, amen, destroy the church and destroy, try to destroy the name of God. Just like the brother said this morning. I mean, listen, you ain't going to let somebody talk about your wife or your husband. All God people saying. Amen. Reprove, rebuke. But he said, exhort. With all long suffering and doctrine. For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine. How many believe we're in that day? Amen. I gotta hurry. Amen. Time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine. Our churches are in a mess. And I don't even like to call them churches. Some of them. Amen. Glory to God. The Bible says, for the time will come, they'll not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lust. Amen. That's the problem. After their own lust. Amen. Shall they heap to themselves teachers having itching ears? Let me tell you something. Something ever happened to this preacher? Amen. If I die, if the Lord leads me somewhere else or whatever. Amen. You had to bury me or if God moves me, whatever. Amen. Here's one thing about it. Ever who's on the pulpit committee, and by the way, let me give a little bit of counsel there. I believe your pulpit committee ought to be your deacon board. You got enough for them, amen, to be your deacons and other faith, they ought to be your pulpit committee. Somebody say amen right there. You might not like it, amen, but that's just good counsel. I've seen too much. You put people, amen, on committees, amen. Find me where God even had a committee in the Word of God. Somebody say amen. Find me somewhere God had a committee, Brother Keith, amen, in the Word of God. They had deacons. Oh, God, people say, but we ain't shouting it out this morning, are we? Amen. Hey, listen, I'm going to say, hey, amen, glory to God, will not endure sound doctrine. Lust, least, amen, they heap to themselves teachers having itching ears, and they shall turn away their ears from the truth and shall be turned into fables. Let me tell you, let me stop right there. I don't know why God's wanting me to do this. But if you ever get to where you're looking for a pastor, amen, you just don't call every Tom, Dick, and Harry. Just because they preach or because they're a preacher or if they call you, pulpit committee, deacon board, amen. Amen. Just because they call you. There's a church recently, amen's without a pastor, and I told my wife, I said, listen, they won't have no problem getting preachers to preach. I said, they won't have nobody. They won't have, amen, no problem preachers picking up the phone and calling them. Giving them the resume. I said, they won't have that. Why? Because it's a good church, amen. And they don't owe no money, amen. And they know that they can take care of a pastor. All God people said. But just anybody don't stand behind that sacred desk. Just any preacher can't pastor this church. How many believe that? It takes God's man that God called to pastor this church. Amen. Amen. Hey, in other words, you, glory to God. If I ever have to go, amen, by death or however, amen. By the way, I ain't planning on going nowhere. If some of you are sitting up there, what is he doing? Is he going in view of a call somewhere? Amen. That's not my intention. Oh, God, people say it. I'm just saying be careful because they will heap to themselves teachers having itching ears. I get up here and preach you the gospel. Amen. We still can't fill a church. Amen. But there's some preachers, amen, get up here, amen, they'll tickle your ears to get the number on the board. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. And they shall be, and they shall turn away their ears from the truth and shall be turned into fables. But watch thou in all things, endure afflictions, do the work of an evangelist, make full proof of thy ministry. You know what the Bible said? You know what that command was of that unchallenged message? We need to carry the message. We have an unchallenged message that's carry, amen, the greatest message ever given. This generation of preachers, amen, are concerning me. I'm telling you, I mean, this generation's coming up, it's bothering me, amen. This generation, amen, it's coming up, hey, glory to God. Hey, no power, no spirit. I mean, they're getting up in their flip-flops and their Bermuda shorts and their Hawaiian shirts. Somebody say amen right there. Hey, a necktie don't call me to preach. A suit coat don't call me to preach. But I'm going to tell you something, friend. Hey, I can't put much confidence in somebody standing up in a Hawaiian shirt, Bermuda shorts, and flip-flops trying to deliver me the gospel. Now, Lord, boy, it got quiet right there. Brother Travis, stand up. I'm trying to teach the church something, okay? How many thank God for the devotion this morning? Do you really? How many it really blessed you this morning? Then you need to let him know that, not to give him a swelled head, amen. Not to, it's God through him. But how many likes the way he looks this morning? Now, Brother Travis, you were doing it anyway, but. You remember me, we was just talking one day and I told you how good you dressed. I'm talking about how I appreciated you getting up and you being the superintendent of this church, Sunday school, how I appreciated you wearing a necktie. Remember me telling you that? Now, I don't think he's wearing a necktie because I bragged on him or more or less asked him to. I think he's doing it on his own, on your own, ain't you, brother? Hey, man, but even that, I respect that. Don't that look more respectable? Boy, it's quiet. I know what you're thinking. Yeah, but preacher, if you'd get up there in your blue jeans, and I ain't wearing no hot rod shirt in the house of God to preach. Now, if I come in, now I'll wear them outside the church. Some people, amen, see me. Thank you, brother. You may be seen. Some people see me up here preaching, amen, some new people, and then they'll see me out in a pair of blue jeans, and they'll see me out in a hot rod shirt. They'll be like, man, I'd have never... It's like, I never thought you would have dressed like that. You probably thought that before, ain't you? What are you saying, preacher? Now, there's nothing wrong with that. But the way I was taught, this is God's house. You know what you... Hey, I said God's house. This ain't your house. It ain't my house. It ain't the community building. Glory to God. Now, let me clear something up. If I got a hot rod t-shirt on and I'm running late for church one night, don't you think I won't preach out of a hot rod shirt? Somebody say amen right there. Everybody with me? I preached amen in a t-shirt and a pair of blue jeans off spur of the moment. How many? Who was there? Was you, sister? Yeah, Sister Jessica was there. It was at Jeff Silver's house. Amen. Well, they were all coming to church here. I mean, we was just out there having, I think, a cookout and things like that. Glory to God. They got up there and said, preach, preacher. I thought, huh? Glory to God. And some of them other preachers, you know what? I preached in my blue jeans. Amen. It don't cause you to preach, but don't it look a little bit more respectable? I'm still old-fashioned. You shouldn't fall out with me on that. Oh, God, don't Jack look good with a necktie on this morning? Now, I ain't saying all you guys have to wear a necktie. That ain't what I'm getting at this morning. Are you with me? Paul Jolly looks good in that polo shirt over. Hallelujah. What color is it? Orange, salmon, whatever you want to call it. Hey, man, I think it looks good on Paul Jolly. How many's getting where I'm going? This new generation of preachers, though, bothering me. This concerning me. Is this anybody relating to what I'm preaching to? I'll be honest with you, I've come too far to change now. Hallelujah. I know what God, I know how God directs me. I know how God leads me. I mean, so many changing with the time. Well, I know, preacher, why, if you'd just tone it down a little bit, and if you would just wear you a polo shirt and a pair of nice khakis and this and that, why, you'd get more people to come to your church. Let me tell you something. If it takes a khaki pair of pants, amen, and a polo shirt to get them here, amen, listen, then the world, hey, I'll tell you what, another church can have them. Why can't they why can't they like a necktie and a coat? All God's people said. Cause it, I know why, preacher. Cause you get up there and you dress in the nice suit and a nice tie. That's what some people say. Or let me tell you something. I like it cause I like it. Don't fall out me cause I like it. Glory to God. I got cowboy boots on today. Amen. One of my preacher, Jack Depp, friends, his name's Jack Depp. Some of you might remember him. Remember in Virginia. Amen. First time I wore my cowboy boots, he gave me a picture. He said, "This is you, preacher." And it was Yosemite Sam. Yosemite Sam. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Makes me a little taller. A little now, brother. What are you saying? Listen, I've come too far to turn back. I've come too far. I've lived too long to change. Let me tell you something. You don't like Jeff Duncan? Hey, man, you in here, you won't like the Jeff Duncan out there. Hey, man, I might not have a suit on out there, but I still have the same values. All God people said, hey, listen, so many are changing with the time. We have a charge to carry an unchallenged message. Amen. Hey, listen, our liberties are being destroyed right before our eyes. Our liberties are being destroyed right before our eyes. Amen. Listen, our Christianity in this nation is being pushed against. It's being destroyed. Hey, this church out there, you know what y'all do? God help that church. And I wouldn't. You say, what if they come? What if Matt Dow County comes and starts fining you? We're going to fine. I don't care how. Hey, we're going to still have service. No difference how many fines we get fined. Now, some of you, amen, money people, amen, you can fall out with that. But I've got more confidence in God than I do that. Glory to God. Amen. I've seen God bless this church too much. We got a new microphone system. Maybe be doing it tomorrow. Maybe doing it tonight. Amen. In the night service. Amen. Yeah, glory to God. Had a gentleman the other day. Amen. I want to say thank God for him. I ain't going to name his name. Amen. We was praying about a projector where I could show you some stuff as I preach sometimes. Everybody with me? Where I can show you some different stuff, amen, while I preach. And amen, in other words, what's it in the time? But anyway, I was praying about that. Well, it ended up costing more, amen, than the pledges that we got. I talked to the deacons about it. Well, guess what happened? Amen. Somebody heard me preaching. Amen. Over the internet, over Facebook. Amen. That watches our service. Amen. Hey, well, glory to God. Well, I'll just say, won't say his name, but it's my friend from Dalton, Georgia. He said, we watch you every Sunday evening, preacher. Amen. You know what he done? I was at his place the other day. He said, how's your church doing? He said, what did that projector system cost? And all that. He started talking about that. And I said, I told him what it's going to cost. You know what he done? He brought a check downstairs and he had a check wrote out for $500. All God people said, you know what the Lord told me? Well, he's providing where we can upgrade just a little bit. Lord's providing where we can upgrade. Amen. The other day, amen, got a phone call. Now, I'm just going to tell this. You think it's all right, James? I'm just going to tell this. Remember James' sister watches faithfully that's in the bed? You know what she done? She called James Amen. She sent him a check. She said, I think the Lord's telling me to help pay on that microphone system. And she said she sent a check for $200. $200. All God people said. And James still got it at home. But how many look back there and say thank you? Hey, look back there at the camera, up over the door and say thank you. To all those, amen. Praise the Lord. Listen to me. I'm telling you, what do you mean, preacher? Thank God that we have. I said our liberties are being taken away. Our Christian liberties, amen, are being challenged. What are they going to do, amen, when they stop these services? They ain't going to stop them. Amen. You say you're defying the law. Listen, there's a difference between man's law and this law. Did you hear this, preacher? Amen. They ain't coming in and stopping this service. You'll go to jail. Then I expect you to bail me out. All God people said, hallelujah. And I expect some of you to go to jail with me. Deacons, you got your pastor's back? Hey, I'm talking about being destroyed. What are they going to do when they take this? You say, I ain't going to take it. Now, they could take this. They can come and physically take your Bible. Don't you think that won't happen? That's the reason I keep trying to pound in your head, how is your Bible reading? That's the reason I keep trying to pound in your head since the first of the year, how's your Bible reading? I'm going to ask how it is, amen, at the end of the year. Not individually, but we're going to see if anybody's ready through. Amen. Not amen that we can flaunt that we're ready, but that we give God the glory that we did. All God's people said, hallelujah. Some of you are scared now. Amen. Hey, when they take this Bible, let me just ask you this. If they did close the church door, well, preacher, are you going to preach anyway? What do you think? There's a street corner out there. I've street preached. Hey man, I've got on the back of a truck, I think one time preached. I walked the whole Christmas parade one year, the whole Christmas parade, and I preached the whole way. How many remember that? Oh, and by the way, we need to get these church vans and everybody in here on them that can get on them and be in that Christmas parade. You say, why? You're just trying to flaunt your church. No, we're not. We're trying to let this community know there's a church here that loves them. Somebody say amen right there. Praise the Lord and let them know that we love them. Hey, we love their soul. Hallelujah. And if some can walk outside, hey, walk and hand people tracks going down through there. All God people said. Hey, listen, we need to remember our charge, amen, for this unchallenged message. We need to carry the message. Listen, what time is this? It's 8 minutes out of 12. I've done too long. Amen, listen. Number two, amen, what is another charge, preacher? An unfinished task. You know the Bible says to go into high wages and hedges and compel them to come in. Hey, we need to use every means we can. I thank God for every, amen, social media format that we have. Sermon audio, I should have printed it out this morning. You wouldn't believe, amen, the messages that they're downloading from this church all over this world. It'll tell which sermon, it'll tell how many times it's been downloaded, what states that are listening in the United States and what countries. Hey, I think we need to wake up. Do we realize we need to use every means we can, at social media that we can, supporting missionaries. How many believe we need to support missionaries and missions? Hey, you know this group of singers, amen, that were coming to the camp meeting? One from Indiana, another from Tennessee. You know what I asked the deacons to do? I said, you pay them just like that's coming. Do you know they have a ministry? Amen. Do you know that they travel and bless your hearts? All God people said? Well, I just don't agree with that, preacher. Then you don't agree, amen, with supporting the work of God. I need help. Boy, it got quiet right there. Well, I just don't agree with that. Then you're disagreeing with God. Amen. Hey, listen, and if the coronavirus don't phase and stir this nation, and by the way, it ain't phasing and it ain't a stirring this nation. only to the fact is people's getting tired of it. Now, I'm talking about if it don't stir and phase this nation spiritually, and it's not, we're in trouble. And some people are expecting a great revival. I'm telling you, I ain't seeing no great revival. Thank God there's a few people getting saved every once in a while. Thank God for that. Amen, but I ain't seeing a great awakening. All God people said, liquor sales were up. Drug sales are up. Murders are up. Amen. People living like the devil, amen, and expecting to go into hell, or expecting to go to heaven when they die. People living it up. You ain't telling me I can't go in the bar. We'll just have it over at the house, and we'll just have all the people we can. We'll have our party there. I need your help this morning. You know the average age, would you listen to this? Do you know the average age of a child that views pornography? The average age of a child viewing pornography, I've been told, 11 years old. Average age viewing pornography. And let me just say this. Once that picture hits their brain, it never leaves. Even after salvation, that picture. See, that brain ain't saved. How many's with the preacher? I mean, 11-year-old girls has to sit with her mom and daddy at a pastor's, amen, canceling, amen, where she has to tell mom and dad, 11 years old, that she's pregnant. Everybody with me? 93% of boys view pornography. 93%. Hey man, 62% of girls view pornography. I need help. 80%, almost 80% of kids are not pure. They're not virgins. Amen. At the age of 20 years old. And you think we ain't living in a troublesome time? You think you better watch your sons, you better watch your daughters. They ain't the saints you think they are. I ain't trying to, well, I got a good kid, thank God for it, but they ain't as good as you think they are. You remember what you done when you was a little boy, when you was a little girl, and you was a teenager. All God people said, oh, preacher, they know how to control that phone. You do have a warped way of thinking. Somebody help preacher this morning. It's late, ain't it? Listen, amen. And you think God's going to bless America with all that filth going on? Are you with me? America has spit in the face of God. It's spit in the face of God. I mean, look at where our nation is right now. And these governors that won't call in for help, it ain't Trump's fault. Now choke on that or swallow a real hard one. Somebody say amen. Is it right or wrong, church? Right or wrong, church? Boy, some of you ain't gonna. Hallelujah. I mean, you think, listen, preachers during this, we have an unfinished task. Preachers during this pandemic is almost glad the church is shut down. Did you know that? Some of you didn't grab that. Preachers in this pandemic, in this shutdown, some preachers, amen, are almost glad. You know why? They're sitting back, don't have to preach. They might can get up, amen, do an online service in their t-shirt or whatever. Somebody say amen. They still get paid their salary. They don't have to visit the hospital. They don't have to visit the sick. Somebody help me. Amen. In other words, well, thank you, Lord. I've got a little bit of break now. I don't have to do all of this. Let me tell you something. Glory to God. I just thank God it's in my heart. Hey, you said, preacher, why did you come up here and preach to an empty congregation? Amen. When it's all settled. You know why? Amen. I'm like old Jeremiah. It's a fire burning in my soul. Hallelujah. I probably could have missed some services and the deacons probably wouldn't have said anything. Amen. I hope before long they would have. Amen? Are you with me? Some preachers are just like, They're glad it shut down. Amen. Oh, something's wrong with that mentality. Amen. With that thinking. 67%. Do you know that I've been told that 67% of the churches are still closed? 67%. I've talked to pastors. I've talked to members. Well, we have Sunday morning service. We don't have Sunday night service. But we have Wednesday night service. Now, you pastors that are listening to this, and you don't have Sunday night service, why not? You have Sunday morning, why not come back Sunday night? I tell you why. It's a little bit more convenient. It's either right or it's wrong. Amen. Some churches are losing. They say that some churches, amen, they're losing, amen, their people, 30%, losing 30% of their people, and they ain't coming back. Thank God that ain't around here. Amen. We wouldn't have but 4 or 5 people. 10 people. All got people saying. Now, we've got some that ain't been coming back, and they're going to have to, I mean, when I say that, amen, listen, I need help. Listen, we have an unfinished task. Amen. We have a charge for the Lord. Number 3, we have a charge for the Lord, of the Lord for unlimited power. In verse number 8, he tells us that we'd receive power after what? That the Holy Ghost has come upon us. Amen. You know what we need more now is the power of God more than ever that we've ever had. We need the power of God now. You don't see young, hey, you ever notice this? Some of you older ones, and I know Brother Tony and some of the, you don't see young men accepting the call to preach right now. When the Lord called me to preach, there's 7 of us in the same church. I'm talking about, man, hey, man, and then after that, you started seeing people, hey, man, accept the call to preach. Even in going home church, hey, man, in its early years. I mean, we had two young men that stood up and said that God had called them to preach. Hey, man, now, hey, man, I don't know if they go to church, but they sure ain't a preaching. Maybe they didn't understand the call, or I don't know. All I know is this. Somebody said, well, maybe God ain't calling. Well, I believe God's calling. Some just ain't listening. Or some, amen, ain't living as close, amen, to where God could call them. You know what that's like? Power. God, we have a challenge and a charge, amen, for the Lord for unlimited power. Do you know that we can have all the power we can have? How many believe that God could still raise the dead? Why ain't we seeing it no more? How many believe that God could take and cause the blinded eyes to be open? You see, now you're getting to one of these healing preachers on TV. Let me tell you something. God can still take somebody in a wheelchair and get them up out of a wheelchair and push the wheelchair out. Do you believe that, Faye? Hey, do you believe that God can take a blinded eye and cause it to see again? God can do that. How many believe God can take cancer and remove the cancer? We've seen that. Hallelujah. Thank God for that. Do you know what? We have had healing services here at this church. Boy, now you get a little bit charismatic on this preacher. It ain't called healing. When I say healing services, I'm talking about where you get God an opportunity God would give you to come up and believe in faith that God can heal your body. You believe God can do that? Who just fell out with me then? You shouldn't have. We have to set the standard. People leaving like hell, expecting to go to heaven when they die, and think that they have all the power of God. I'm going to tell you something. You can't have the power of God and live like hell at the same time. Fourthly, let me say we have a charge for an unshakable testimony. Do you know we got the sure word of God? We've got the sure word of prophecy, and that is the word of God. This book is powerful, sharper than a two-edged sword. I'm going to close in just a second. We got a piano player. Keith, can you play the piano? Amen. No time to sit down, church. No time to quit. No time to be lazy. I mean, how's your testimony during this pandemic? I'm going to ask you that again. How's your testimony in this pandemic? Hey, we need preaching with power. We need singing with power. We need teaching with power. We need witnessing with power. We have a charge for an unshakable testimony. Actually, some of your family ain't saved. Your testimony ain't strong. Whoop! That's the reason some of your family ain't saved. Your testimony ain't strong. Hey, let me just say it again. Let me say this then. All right? Why can't you get them to the house of God? Because your testimony ain't strong. Why you got lost family and lost children and lost husbands and lost wives? Amen. I tell you why. How's your testimony? What are you presenting to them? If you can cuss like a sailor and dress like a floozy, somebody say amen. See, I believe in God. You remember when God saved the maniac of Gadara? How many remember that? Amen. The Bible says he wasn't in his right mind. Amen. He was in the tombs. He was cutting himself. He wasn't clothed. Amen. He was running around naked. Amen. But when Jesus passed by that day, hallelujah. Bible says, you know what the Bible says? Say it, Brother Travis. He was clothed. When you get saved, you put clothes on. You don't take clothes off. He was clothed and in his right mind. Whoopee. Enough said. You'll say amen to that one? How's your testimony? Does your testimony shine? Fifthly, and I'm going to close. Who can play the piano that's been holding back on us? Who can play one gospel song on the piano that's been holding back on us? Who's got a guitar? Come play me something, brother. Huh? Ain't got it up here with you? If you got a CD there, a Mike Blanton and Evans, won't you play me a song? We got an unfailing promise. I want you to look at verse 2, 10, and 11 in that same chapter. Verse 2 said, until the day in which he was taken up, after that through the Holy Ghost had given commandments unto the apostles whom he had chosen. Verse 10 and 11. And while they looked steadfastly toward heaven as he went up, behold, two men stood by in white apparel, which also said, ye men of Galilee, why stand ye gazing up into heaven? This same Jesus, which is taken up from you into heaven, shall so come in like manner as ye have seen him go into heaven. How many believe Jesus is coming? We got an unfailing promise. Amen. Jesus is coming. Amen. We have hope, church. Hey, church, we have hope. Amen. How many believe we got hope? If you're here this morning and you're lost, he said, all that shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. You say, preacher, I've done that. But now I'm in a vaccine condition. Hey, preacher, I've been to that altar and confessed, and I've went back out and I've messed up my life. I've come to the altar and confessed, and I've went back out and messed up my life. Let me tell you something. Hey, man, God's given you grace and God's given you mercy, and he's given you an opportunity to get to this altar this morning. That's good, brother. Stand our feet. Turn it up. Keep, turn it up a little more.
Like Jesus, he's all I need.
Won't you bring it to Jesus this morning?
He's all I need. He's all,
he's all you need this morning.
Sometimes the way is long and hard. Sometimes I don't feel like traveling on. Sometimes I'm pierced by Satan's darts. And sometimes I just want to go home.